Now, almost everywhere you go in this country, you'll find professional video photographers who shoot weddings and conferences and other special occasions. Well, here, there's a family company who also shoot DVDs of rural history with the help of Monaghan Veteran and Vintage Club. Already, they've recorded and explained traditional skills like turf cutting, butter churning and poutine making. And Niall Martin caught up with them, they're the Murphy family, as they were gathering some more stories from times past.
Today the Murphy family are filming the President's visit to a new house for people with mental handicap just outside Monaghan town. It's the sort of work that records present day life around the county. Important milestones in local development.
They bring such joy and life to us, don't they?
But there's another side to this Emmyvale family business. For the last 8 years, they've been faithfully recording a lost way of life, from the dubious smuggling tradition, the everyday skills of the potato farmer, to the illicit secrets of the poutine maker. The Murphys have captured each custom and tradition from start to finish.
Well, it started back in the mid-90s. My father had started the business back in the early 90s, and just from filming a few vintage rallies and that, just some of the club members and that got the ideas of maybe trying to record some of the old traditions and pastimes that are now dead and gone type of thing, just to have some sort of a record for the future. Whenever I was going to school, history was learning dates and different things, but like there's a lot more local social history that's, you know, forgotten about now, you know, like that my father would have taught us down the years or told us about, and like you could never imagine it until you actually see it in operation. And through the help of the Vintage Club here in the county and that, they've reenacted a lot of what used to go on years ago, and just to see how hard it was, how life was so hard back then.
The DVDs Fabian, his brother Gregory and their father Frank produce are detailed how-to-do manuals for future generations to understand. Members of the Monaghan Veteran and Vintage Club dress in period costume to bring the old traditions back to life. And narrator Padraig McMahon explains how things were done in the old days. Take the production of butter, for example.
Milk for churning was kept in earthenware crocks for about 10 days until it was completely soured. An important feature of good butter making was proper sterilisation of all the equipment being used. Churning usually took 35 to 40 minutes of continuous dashing. If a neighbour called, it was considered bad luck not to give them a turn at the dashing. A scoop was used to lift the butter from the churn, and now began a process of washing all the buttermilk out of the butter by means of tossing and teasing in cold water. Salt was also added to improve the flavour. Butter pats were used to mould the butter into shape. A harvest fit for any table.
Along the border, smuggling has always been rife, and the olden days videos recreate the intrepid encounters between the customs men and local smugglers.
Roads clear.
Customs here. Can I look in the back?
That's no problem. What have you got here?
Oh, there's only a few little pigs.
Oh, you're smuggling pigs.
No, no, them's only neighbours. We're just delivering them.
We're going to have to impound those pigs.
I'll tell you what. I'll see you later.
All filmmakers need a props department, and the Murphys have access to a top-class one. In this shed is a treasure trove of bric-a-brac collected by Sean Moan, who also plays many roles in the videos.
And I've collected nearly everything that's old in any of the South, from coaches to carts. I have coaches there from 1840, I have a horse there from 1836. And all coaches, all bits, all things were used years ago, all around the farms in County Mullen. I think the old ways was a great way of living.
It was tough,
but times was happier. I think there was better times, people was happier at the time. Everybody helped other out, if you hadn't got a horse's cart, you borrowed off your neighbour, and if he had a horse rolling, you borrowed the horse, you switched about all the time. Even the horses, maybe one man, I had a horse and my neighbour had a horse, so we joined up for the ploughing and for the mowing the corn, the digging of the spuds, all that. I remember we were making a video and we were putting in the potatoes, and a very high qualified fella come down and he says to me, "Is that the way you grow the potatoes?" He says, "Where do you think you got it?" "In the shelf." I says, "That's how they come to be on the shelf." And he was rare in the country, he wasn't a townie. He was just a country fella, he hadn't a clue. Never. He went to college, way into books and computers and laptops and all the rest. But he didn't know how the spud was grown.
The Murphys have already produced 3 DVDs with the Vintage Club, and there are plans for a new one soon.
Oh, they sell worldwide, like America, Canada, Australia, France, England. They've sold everywhere, just with people that emigrated maybe years ago. Their families that are still around have sent them out these just as a memory of times gone past.
You can see the implements of yesteryear in many county museums, but it's the way these films have injected life into those old tools that give us an insight into our forefathers' tough lives and occasional comforts.